The Seleka and the Anti-Balaka are basically not very different. They're both a loose coalition of militiamen. The Seleka fighters were basically made of armed groups coming from the northeast of the country, who have been active for 5 or 6 years, and who were joined by mercenaries coming from Chad and Sudan. That's basically was the core of the Seleka fighters. After, of course, they recruited some unemployed young people along the way to Bangui. When it comes to the Anti-Balaka militia, they are mainly made of villagers coming from the western part of the country, and especially the Baya tribe, with the tribe of the former President Bozizé. They've been joined by former military personnel, and now also a lot of young people in Bangui are joining the ranks of the Anti-Balaka. This is not a Christian-Muslim thing, it's basically Muslims were targeted by the Anti-Balaka militia, who is made of Christian and animist people, but they are not doing this for, I would say, religious reasons. This is not a religious conflict. They are doing this because they assimilated the Muslim community to the Seleka fighters, and because they have a long-term resentment against some Muslim groups within the Central African Republic society. There is a long-term resentment against the pastoralists, for instance, who are mainly Muslims, because of the usual conflict between farmers and pastoralists. There is also a long-term resentment against Muslim traders, because they are seen as the wealthy people who have actually benefited from years of exploitation in Central Africa Republic. So the first phase of the Anti-Balaka was a self-defense reaction. Basically, they were villagers who organized themselves last year to resist against the Seleka fighters. And the second phase was actually when some former military personnel integrated into the Anti-Balaka and basically took control of their operations. And the last phase was when some politicians tried to take control of the movement and basically created two factions of Anti-Balaka, one called the Front de Résistance and another one called the CLPC. So from a political perspective, these are the two entities representing the Anti-Balaka. But it's still a very loose coalition of fighters, and I would say the control of the various commanders of the Anti-Balaka by the politician is thin. The Seleka as a coalition does not exist anymore. It disaggregated into several armed groups. And our understanding is that the foreign mercenaries went back to Chad and Sudan, and the local militiamen went back to their area, basically the east and northeast part of the country.